What's going on, guys? It's Mesmer here, and welcome to a NatType opening video for Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. So I'm just going to jump straight into it here. I'm on Windows 10, so hopefully you guys are too. Windows 10 is pretty good. It's come a long way from what it was when it first got released. They've seemed to sort out most of the bugs, and I'm really liking it from now on. So I've just made a list here. This can all be found at this link. I will put all this in the description of the video so you can copy paste and use all of these at your free will. But that's their website right there. So I've just arranged all the ports that we'll need for this video. So Call of Duty Infinite Warfare PC, PS4, Xbox One. You'll notice that most of them share the exact same ports. That's because this 3074 is their main port that they transfer their traffic through. So that will be in pretty much every Call of Duty ever made. So the first thing we need to do right here is press and hold the Windows key and then X on the keyboard, and it'll bring up this little box right here. This will work from Windows 7, I believe, onwards. So then you can see this here. You can use your mouse to move around, or what I usually do is I just press Windows key and then C. Brings up the command prompt straight away. Then what we need to do is press, type in ipconfig. No space in between that, no space at the end, just enter. And then you can see here we've got, it'll show all of your adapters, so you can see all this stuff here. It doesn't really matter if I show you, so I don't really care. Then we've got this one right here, the IPv4 address. We need to copy that one. So this is an internal IP. No one can access your internet through that IP right there because it is within your own network. So if you check your own computer this way, you may even have something similar. That number never gets out of your network, so you don't have to worry if someone tries to DDoS that number, because they'll probably DDoS themselves. So kudos to them. Then what we need to do is press and hold the Windows and the X again, and you can see File Explorer there. It's underlined with the E, so we just press Windows X and then E. Brings up the File Explorer, go to Network, and then you've got the Archer D5. That's my network infrastructure. Yours might be different unless you have the exact same router as me. So what we need to do is we've got my computer, media devices, and then other blah blah blah. You need to right click on this and go to properties. Now this will take a while to load because it basically has to get the information from the server that's holding your information for your router. So we can see here, brought that up. We've got go to settings, and you can see that I've already added these. So basically I'll just delete them and delete all of these so it shows what it would look like if there's nothing added. So you go to settings, you go add. Then you go, you can call this whatever you want as long as you understand what it exactly is. So COD Infinite Warfare, the name or IP, once again, this is this number right here. So you just want to highlight that if you're on Windows 10. You can just then press Control C and then Control V straight into that box right there. So that's a great feature with Windows 10 that's that they've added. We don't need that screen anymore. This is where we need to go to my little notepad right here. We can see we've got 3074 under the TCP. So let's go ahead and put that one in. 3074, TCP, same one for that. Press OK, and now that's added. Now we need to do the same for the other one. And you can have these named the exact same so it won't conflict with anything else. Then you need to grab your internal IPv4 address again. Right there, then we'll go to UDP 3074, exact same thing, 3074, press OK, and now we've added those two ports. They're the two main ones. If you find you still got a strict or moderate NAT type after that, you may need to go through and add most of these ports. It will all depend on how strict your infrastructure is with your internet and your firewall. So yeah, you'll need to add each individual port if you are having any troubles. But if you are having any troubles, just leave a comment in the comment section below on this video. All the links will be in the description, and hopefully it all goes smoothly. So yeah, once again, this is Mesmer, and I'll catch you in the next video.